Hello everyone, and welcome to the course of Mechanical System Design, in which we are learning about design of IC engine components. In the previous lecture, we learned design of piston pin, and with that we concluded the design of piston and associated components. In this lecture, we will learn about design of connecting rod. A connecting rod is one of the most challenging and interesting component to be designed in an engine. It's a lengthy topic, so we have split it into two lectures. In this lecture, we will learn about design of shank of a connecting rod. The function of a connecting rod is, one of the function is transmit the gas force from piston to the crankshaft. In some cases, it carries lubricating oil from the crank pin to the piston pin through a hole drilled along the length of the connecting rod. Connecting rod is continuously subjected to the reversed compressive and tensile forces. Hence, the desirable material properties are that it should have high fatigue strength and high resilience. Therefore, the materials preferred for connecting rod construction are medium carbon steels and alloy steels. Owing to the requirement of strength and ease in manufacturing, drop forging is the process preferred for the manufacturing of the connecting rod. Let us understand the construction. Connecting rod comprises of three main components, the small end, the big end, and they are connected with the help of a shank. Small end conceals a small end bearing inside it. The big end is split into two halves. One half is integrated with the shank, whereas the other half is removable. This split end of the connecting rod helps in assembling the bearing at the big end and also helping in clamping the crank pin of a crankshaft. This spare end of the big end is called as big end bearing cap. This cap is clamped to the connecting rod with the help of nut bolt arrangement. Shank of a connecting rod is made up of an eye section. The reason of using eye section is that it is excellent when it comes to tackling the buckling and bending stresses. Eye section has the highest section modulus. That means the ratio of area moment of inertia to the distance of the farthest fiber from the neutral axis. And that is the reason wherever higher bending stresses are experienced, eye sections are used. Another geometrical property which we want to discuss over here is the ratio of L to R, which is called as obliquity ratio, and it is ratio of connecting rod length L to the crank radius R. The angle made by the connecting rod with the axis of cylinder is denoted by phi, whereas angle made by the crank with the axis of cylinder is denoted by theta. Axis of cylinder is also called as line of action of piston. The obliquity ratio is generally close to 3. However, it can be higher or lower than 3. Let us understand their merits and demerits. Higher obliquity ratio results in the lower angle subtended by the connecting rod with the axis of cylinder, which results in lower thrust forces. However, the length of the engine or height of the engine will be more in this case. On the other hand, if obliquity ratio is lesser, it results in higher angle phi, that is the angle made by connecting rod with the axis of cylinder. Due to the higher angle, it results in higher value of thrust forces on the walls of the cylinder. This design results in lower height of the engine. Thus, the designers choose the obliquity ratio depending upon their requirement. Another issue with lower value of obliquity ratio is that the piston skirt has to be designed carefully so that the connecting rod should not foul with the piston skirt under limiting conditions. So these are the things which need to be taken care while designing the connecting rod. Let us understand the formulae for design of the connecting rod shank. The cross section of the shank is I section and its dimensions are based on a parameter which is thickness of the web and flange denoted by T in this diagram. The height of the cross section is 5 times T and the breadth of the cross section is 4 times T. Two axes are denoted over here, XX and YY, so that we can calculate the various sectional properties about these two axes. Below are some of the sectional properties of the cross section of the shank. AC is the cross sectional area of the shank given by 11T square. IYY is the area moment of inertia of a connecting rod given by 34.9167 T raised to 4. IXX is the area moment of connecting rod about XX axis given by 10.9167 T raised to 4. KYY and KXX are the radius of variation of a cross section of a connecting rod about YY and XX axis respectively. Radius of gyration is the function of cross-section area and area moment of inertia. It is related by the equation that I is equal to AK square. Thus, if I and A is known, K can be calculated. Thus, KY comes out to be 1.78160 and KXX comes out to be 0.9962T. These properties of area will be required while designing the shank of a connecting rod. The first failure mode of a connecting rod is by buckling. The photos on the right hand side will exhibit the buckling of a connecting rod about YY axis in the first photo and buckling of a connecting rod about XX axis. The formula for critical buckling load is given in this box. FCR is equal to SYC AC upon 1 plus alpha LE upon K whole square. In this formula, FCR is the critical buckling load, SYC is compressive yield strength of connecting rod material. Please note that it is SYC and not SYT. SYC is taken as 25% higher than SYT. AC is the cross sectional area of the shank. Alpha is the Rankine constant given by 1 upon 7500 for steel. LE is equivalent length of connecting rod, whose value is equal to L for both ends hinged and its value is equal to 0.5L for both ends fixed. K is the radius of gyration of cross section area of the connecting rod. This FCR has to be equal to NF FG max, where NF is factor of safety taken for this design, which lies between 4 to 6, and FG max is the maximum gas force. The second mode of failure in case of connecting rod is failure due to the inertia forces. Now, connecting rod has a very complicated motion. The small end of a connecting rod has a reciprocating motion moving along with the piston, whereas big end of the connecting rod is having pure rotational motion moving along with the crankshaft. Thus, it has got a composite motion which makes it very difficult to design. Thus, the inertia forces can be divided into longitudinal component and transfer component. The inertia forces due to longitudinal components are taken care by considering 1/3 mass of connecting rod into the mass of the piston while balancing the reciprocating masses of the engine. Therefore, in this design, only transverse component of the inertia force has to be taken care of. This transverse component, as the name suggests, is perpendicular to the length of the connecting rod. It introduces the bending stresses in the body of the connecting rod. This bending stress is called as whipping stress. Now try to understand what is the whipping stress. This whipping stress is introduced due to sudden change in the direction of the motion of the connecting rod. For example, while playing a badminton, when a player smashes the shuttle, there is sudden change in the direction of the racket, which introduces a whipping stress in it, which is essentially a bending stress. Another example can be, in cricket, if a bowler has bowled a Yorker length delivery, then a right-handed batsman will clear his left leg and slap the ball over mid-wicket. This shot is also called as helicopter shot. In this shot, there is sudden change in the direction of the bat, which introduces very high bending stresses in the bat. The situation of the connecting rod in the engine is quite similar to these situations. There is sudden change in the direction of motion of the connecting rod, which introduces very high bending stresses in the connecting rod, called as whipping stress. If you see the geometry over here, you can conclude that whipping stress is maximum when theta plus phi is equal to 90 degrees, that is when connecting rod is perpendicular to the crank. The whipping stress is minimum and its value is equal to 0 when theta plus phi is equal to 0 degrees, which means the connecting rod and the crank are lying on the same line. This situation occurs when the piston is either at TDC or at BDC. Thus, a bending moment diagram of the connecting rod has to be plotted. A maximum bending moment has been calculated, and then the bending stress due to this maximum bending moment is derived. It is represented in this formula as sigma BW is equal to rho AC omega square RL square upon 9 under root 3Z, where sigma BW is the maximum whipping stress, rho is the mass density of the material, AC is the cross section area of the shank, omega is the angular speed of the crank, R is the crank radius, L is the length of connecting rod, and Z is the section modulus of shank about YY axis. Let us try to design shank of a connecting rod by these two concepts. Please go through the problem statement carefully. You may pause the video to understand this problem statement properly. For the ease of understanding, the notations of various parameters are mentioned wherever a data is found. There are 5 questions in this numerical problem, and we will be attempting to solve the first and the fifth question, that is the dimensions of the cross section of the connecting rod and the magnitude of whipping stress. We have already assumed the cross section of connecting rod having height 5t and breadth 4t. First, we will solve for buckling about YY axis, and the critical load formula is given in the box. Here FCR is given by NF into FG max, where NF is the factor of safety given as 5. FG max is calculated as pi by 4 d square into P max, that is the cross section area into maximum gas pressure. SYC is considered as 1.25 times the SYT. AC is the cross sectional area given by 11 t square. Alpha is taken as 1 upon 7500. LE in this case is taken as equal to L, since if we consider buckling about YY axis, both the ends of the connecting rod are pinned. K can be calculated from area and area moment of inertia, which is given by 34.9167 T raised to 4. So KYYY comes out to be 1.78160. If you observe all this data, apart from the parameter T, everything else is known. So we can solve this equation for T, which comes out to be 4.516 mm, which is rounded off to 4.6 mm. Thus, all other dimensions of a cross section can be calculated, such as width of flange comes out to be 18.4 mm and depth of section as 23 mm. We have to check the stresses or the critical load due to buckling about XX axis by using the same formula. The only change will be now both ends will be fixed, so equivalent length comes out to be 0.5L. And since it is a XX section, we have to consider radius gyration about XX section, which comes out to be 0.9962T. The critical buckling load in this case comes out to be 92,565.49 N. We can calculate the factor of safety by dividing the critical load by the maximum gas force, which comes out to be 5.437, which is greater than 5, which concludes that the connecting rod is safe for buckling about XX axis as well. Let us calculate the whipping stress introduced into the connecting rod by the formula sigma BW equal to sigma IC omega square RL square upon 9 under root 3Z. In this formula, almost all of the values are known. Some of the new values are calculated as, such as omega is given by 2 pi n by 60. R is the crank radius given by stroke divided by 2. Z is the section modulus about yy axis given by area moment of inertia about yy axis divided by the distance of farthest fiber from the neutral axis, which is yy. So it is h by 2. By putting all the known values, we get sigma BW as 92.048 Newton per mm square. Sigma allowable is the tensile yield strength divided by the factor of safety, which comes out to be 95 Newton per mm square. It can be observed that the whipping stress introduced is less than the allowable stress, making this connecting rod safe in whipping stress as well. In this way, the shank of the connecting rod can be designed. In the next lecture, we will learn design of the small end, big end, and big end bearing cap. Thank you.